Google search results page has evolved over the years from a page that once just showed a plain list of links and descriptions to a page that now displays a rich listing of search results with many added features. But with all these new features, you feel sometimes like your page is getting lost among everything else. Today, we are going to talk about structured data and how it can help you stand out among the crowd of today's search results. Hi, I'm Phil Sparks with Guiding Digital. We're going to be bringing you videos on this channel about website best practices. So if you're a developer, a marketer, or small business owner wanting to refine your skills and get your content noticed, this channel is for you. So subscribe below to stay informed about future content. Today, we're going to talk about structured data. This is going to be the first of two videos on the topic. In this first video, I'm going to talk about what structured data is, and then talk about the benefits of implementing structured data. In the second video, we'll get hands-on and talk about how you can implement structured data on your website. So what is structured data? Structured data is a standardized format for providing context about web content. It's also referred to as schema markup. Google and other search engines use this structured data to better understand your content. To illustrate the need for structured content, let's use an example of a typical recipe page. If you have a recipe page with an intro that says, "This chicken casserole serves 6 and is only 300 calories per serving," and then it lists out the ingredients and directions that are needed. Google will crawl your recipe, but it may be hard for Google to determine the individual parts of your recipe, like the nutritional information or the ingredients and directions. By using structured data, you can make sure that Google knows that the serving size is 6, the number of calories is 300, it'll know the ingredients that are needed and each step in making the recipe. You accomplish this by giving information to Google through a standardized vocabulary and format. The vocabulary is defined by an organization called schema.org. Schema.org is a joint effort between Google, Bing, and several other search providers that defines a common list of schema types and properties that can be used within schema markup. Currently, they have created 615 different types. Don't let this number overwhelm you. In my second video, I'll suggest the ones that I recommend you start with. Schema.org defines a standard vocabulary, but you have several choices for the format. You can use microdata, RDFA, or JSON-LD. Google recommends JSON-LD, and so that's the one we'll focus on in our next video, where we go over the practical steps of how you can implement structured data on your website. So now we know the basics of what structured data is, and we know the problem it's trying to solve, let's talk about what it can do for your website. The first benefit is increased visibility in Google search results through what are called rich results. Years ago, Google search results were just a plain-looking list of results with basically just a title and description for each result. Now Google adds many rich features to the search results. To illustrate this, just type in a common search term like apple pie. For this one search result, you have multiple examples of rich results features. We see apple pie recipes at the top, we have entries with user-submitted ratings, we have images and a knowledge graph on the right column with facts about apple pie and nutritional information. Scrolling down, we have videos and popular products, common questions, and even a way to refine your search by the brand of apple pie. Here's another example. In this example, I've searched for landscaping. Google has returned a list of pages that it thinks are relevant for me based on my location. You have your paid results and the Google map and listing for local results. You have others with the normal title and description, and then you have this one with frequently asked questions. It takes up twice the real estate as the others. How did they get it to look like this? If you follow the link, you'll see that they have questions and answers section, and if you were to dig into the technical details, you'd find that they have included the appropriate structured data to tell Google that this list of questions and answers are officially frequently asked questions. This is just one example of a rich search feature that can make your search results stand out. A few more examples of ones that are attainable are recipes, ratings, products, events, and videos. This increased visibility in Google search results leads us to the next benefit. The next benefit is an increased click-through rate. There are mixed opinions on whether structured data affects your search rankings. Google has gone on the record in stating that the presence of structured data is not a ranking signal. An example of a ranking signal are things like performance or the use of SSL on your site. For these things, Google has stated clearly that you will be rewarded for performance or penalized for lack of performance. So if structured data doesn't affect where your page will show up in Google search results, why does it even matter? Well, I've already gone over how adding structured data can enable rich search features. These rich search features give you added visibility, and case studies have pointed to an increased click-through rate because of this increased visibility. Click-through rate indicates the percentage of users that saw your page in search results and then clicked on the link to go to your page, And so if you have a CTR of 3%, your page was included in 100 users' search results, a click-through rate of 3% means that 3 out of 100 clicked on the link to visit your page. So how much of an increase can this give you? According to Martha Van Berkel at Schema App, they typically see a 20% increase in CTR when implementing structured data. Eric Inge at Proficient Digital published the results of a recent study that focused on how search features impact CTR. His study found that the aggregate CTR for results in the top 10 for branded queries was about 71%, and for non-branded, around 38%. Google has several case studies on their site that also point to improved CTR and other metrics. I'll include the link to their case studies in the video description. The next benefit to structured data is that you help Google know that your pages are more relevant by giving them the needed context. I've already mentioned that Google does not consider the presence of structured data a ranking signal, and so it doesn't give or take away quality points based on the presence of structured data. But don't take that fact as meaning they can't affect search results positioning with structured data. One of Google's primary goals is to deliver most relevant search results that matches the searcher's intent. That is why Google customizes search results based on location. If someone is searching for a place to buy a wedding cake, it will place local bakers higher in the search results. So how does this relate to structured data? Structured data gives Google additional context for your data. So let's say you are a baker in a city called Springdale. Someone doing a search for Springdale Baker might find your shop, but without the presence of structured data, you're relying on a lot of factors on whether or not Google will associate your shop with Springdale. From Google's perspective, it may not be able to make that association with a high degree of certainty. However, if you include structured data that clearly defines your city as Springdale, Google now has the information needed to be sure of your shop's location. You will be more likely to show up higher in a search for Springdale Baker or Baker near me. In this video, I hope I clarified what is meant by structured data and why you need it on your site. In the next video, we'll take a look at how to implement it on your site. The question of the day is, what success stories have you had using structured data? As always, thanks for watching. If you found this video useful, give me a like, and make sure and subscribe if you want more content on web best practices. Also, feel free to leave me a comment or question below, and I'll try to respond to each one. Thanks.